For the last weeks, we have been growing spinach and some strawberry seedlings in our NFT system. The spinach is ready to be harvested and the strawberries will bloom soon. Next, we decided to try and grow some flowers to get some color in the dark, long winter in Norway. However, our old light has a limited cold white spectrum. This is only suitable for green plants and not for flowering or fruiting. Luckily, Spider Farmer came to the rescue and sent us this full-spectrum grow light. This new light can be used for all plants and plant stages, and it's also the perfect size for our NFT system. Let's have a look at what's inside. This is the SF600 version, which is longer and more powerful than the SF300. The light looks to be well protected in the package. This is the power supply, which has been upgraded in the 2023 version of the light. This is the wire suspension kit. It doesn't weigh much, but it still feels solid. The new power supply, together with highly efficient osram LEDs, gives a very high efficacy of 2.3 micromole per joule. The light also has a massive aluminium shell for very good heat dissipation. Let's have a look at the manual. As you can see, it's a full spectrum with peaks in red and blue, which is extra important for photosynthesis. The spectrum consists of 660 nanometer red diodes, 740 nanometer infrared diodes, as well as warm and cold white diodes, for a total of 384 osram diodes. It draws 75 watts and is 100 centimeters long. It weighs only 1.43 kilos. The wire suspension kit includes two wires, wire clamps, and connectors for the light. The power cord is easy to connect at the side of the light. Let's plug it in. Here you can see what the different diodes looks like. Here is a side-by-side comparison with the old light. Let's remove the old light. We will reuse the wire hanging from the roof. Since there are two wires on each side, we have to use a slightly larger wire clamp than the one included. Thank you. The hanging height is shown on the Spider Farmer website. Since we hang the light between two rows, we hang it a bit closer. We harvest the rest of the spinach. Now the strawberries can start to bloom in this pleasant indoor sunlight. We use our usual stock A and B solution, which is made of 100 grams crystalline indigo and 100 grams calcinit per 1 liter water. We start off with 40 milliliters of each, but will increase to 50 milliliters when the plant gets bigger. The water is flowing nicely through the channels. In addition to the strawberries, we have grown some seedlings that will flower. This is marigold, which will give beautiful orange flowers, which is edible. Next is some chamomile, since we want to try and make chamomile tea. We also plant some lettuce and basil, so we get a wide variety of plants in our kitchen garden. Looks really good! Notice how all the light is reflected downwards, making it comfortable to look at. We are looking forward to coming down to the kitchen every morning, seeing how much they have grown. Let's do a quick pH check. This yellow color means a pH of about 6, which is perfect. We also notice that the light runs really cool. The surface temperature is only about 40 degrees Celsius. We put up a camera and we'll make a time lapse of the growth. Our cat is very interested in following the growth, so stay tuned for our next episode. Here is a short preview of the time lapse. In the next video, we will also discuss pH and air humidity challenges during winter time. In the third part, we will hopefully eat sweet strawberries and drink some chamomile tea.